In this video, I'll demonstrate using scalar data types in action. To begin, I'll open up my terminal and create a new cargo project for scalars. I will start at my REST projects directory, and once I'm there, I will type cargo new scalars and go ahead and create this new scalars package. And I will cd to move into the scalars directory. And once there, I will use the shortcut to open up Visual Studio Code. So with Visual Studio Code open, I'll go ahead under source and main.rs and focus my attention there. So I'll go ahead and close the sidebar so we can just focus on the full program view. And what we're going to start to do is just explore different examples of creating scalar data types. So let's go ahead and start with integers. I'll go ahead and just remove the print statement and replace that with a new variable called a, which I will say this is equal to 5. And just a reminder, this is going to be an I32 data type. I can also see that annotated here with REST Analyzer. Going forward, I just won't do any comments to add that, but just helpful, especially to know if you want to add any comments after a line, just to provide a little bit more information for yourself or for any of the readers of the program. So next, let me define another variable called b, and I will say that b is, let's say that this is specifically going to be an unsigned 8-bit integer n equal to 1. So next, let's look at floating point numbers. I'm going to go ahead and declare a couple different variables for floating point numbers. So first, let's have let x is going to be equal to the value of 2.0. And I see that by default, this is the F64 type. Next, I'm going to have a value y and give y the explicit type of F32 is equal to 3.0. And add a semicolon at the end. Next, I want to start to use some of these variables that we've declared and do different mathematical operations. So I'm going to have let sum is equal to, let's add up a and b and put a semicolon at the end of that. Notice that sum becomes type U8. So it just goes ahead and chooses a type. Then I want to have let difference. And what I can do here is let's look at our floating point numbers. How about we take x minus 1.0 and add a semicolon at the end of that line. I see that this is the float 64 type still. Next, let's look at products and let's take our variable a into account. So we can say something like 4 times a and get that value there, which would be 20. We can then look at, let's say, the quotient and how to divide different scalar types that we have. So let's now look at our floating point numbers again. We can take 9.0 perhaps divided by y. That would give us a nice, I'm just going to go out and say 9.0 divided by y, which would result in 3.0. And next, let's just look at the last kind of most common operation used, which would be the remainder. So I can say let remainder is equal to a modulo b. So we can take the remainder of a into b. So that's just giving you an idea of how we can use these different mathematical operations with different variables and data types that we've already defined. And what I'd like to look at next is how to define some Boolean types. So let's go ahead and just define a couple variables. Let t is equal to true. So again, the REST compiler just automatically picks up that this is a Boolean type. I can also say let f and use that bool keyword there and set this f variable to false. And then finally, I just wanted to look at a couple examples of characters. Let's go ahead and first look at the example of using an emoji character. So I can say let c is equal to, I'm going to put the single quote in here. You notice that REST Analyzer already picked up that this was a car because of that. And I just had this emoji copied into my clipboard so I can come and paste that here. And then finally, I can say let d colon specify that this is actually a character type is equal to a, and I'm going to hold my a to bring up that little toolbar and press 1 so we can use some kind of accented letter. And so those are just a couple examples of characters. So I'm going to go ahead and save this program for now. Well, you see it's a little bit messy. There's a lot going on here. I have some warnings, but let's just go ahead and run this for now in the terminal and see what happens. So I'm going to open my terminal and I'm going to say cargo run. And I see that my program piles, and then I do get a number of warnings. The compiler is telling me if this is intentional, if it's not meant to be used, because this is an unused variable warning, then I can prefix it with an underscore. If I do want to use the variable, I could also add a print statement. So if you like, fix up the warnings as an extra challenge. You can also continue to use the Scalars project to explore how to use scalar data types in your programs.